Captain Jim was buried in the little over-harbor graveyard, very near to the spot where the wee white lady slept. His relatives put up a very expensive, very ugly monument, a monument at which he would have poked sly fun had he seen it in life. But his real monument was in the hearts of those who knew him, and in the book that was to live for generations. Leslie mourned that Captain Jim had not lived to see the amazing success of it. How he would have delighted in the reviews, they're almost all so kindly, and to have seen his life book heading the lists of the best sellers. Oh, if he could have just lived to see it, Anne! But Anne, despite her grief, was wiser. It was the book itself he cared for, Leslie, not what might be said of it. And he had it. He had read it all through. That last night must have been one of the greatest happiness for him, with the quick, painless ending he had hoped for in the morning. I am glad for Owen's sake and yours that the book is such a success, but Captain Jim was satisfied, I know. The lighthouse star still kept a nightly vigil. A substitute keeper had been sent to the point until such time as an all-wise government could decide which of many applicants was best fitted for the place, or had the strongest pull. The first mate was at home in the little house, beloved by Anne and Gilbert and Leslie, and tolerated by a Susan who had small liking for cats. "I can put up with him for the sake of Captain Jim, Mrs. Dr. dear, for I liked the old man, and I will see that he gets bite and sup, and every mouse the traps account for. But do not ask me to do more than that, Mrs. Dr. dear. Cats is cats, and take my word for it, they will never be anything else. And at least, Mrs. Dr. dear, do keep him away from the blessed wee man. Picture to yourself how awful it would be if he was to suck the darling's breath." "That might fitly be called a catastrophe," said Gilbert. "Oh, you may laugh, Dr. dear, but it would be no laughing matter." "Cats never suck babies' breaths," said Gilbert. "That is only an old superstition, Susan." "Oh, well, it may be a superstition or it may not, Dr. dear. All that I know is it has happened. My sister's husband's nephew's wife's cat sucked their baby's breath, and the poor innocent was all but gone when they found it. And superstition or not, if I find that yellow beast lurking near our baby, I will whack him with the poker, Mrs. Dr. dear."